Now we'll see another example, and this is the communication all-to-all personalized communication over a mesh topology. Okay, so by diagram it looks very complex, but it is very simple. This I will make it simple. So what is this? This is a mesh, right? So it's a two-dimensional structure in the sense it has x-axis, it has a y-axis, or in simple language it has rows and it has a column. Okay, now see here how many processes are there. 3 by 3, so total there are 9 processes. So we are starting indices from 0, so it will be 0 to 8. Okay, now see that communication will be done in only 2 steps. This is the first step and this is the second step. Okay, so I will start it. So every node has some messages that I have told. Likewise, every node has a message. Now see, there are total 9 processes. So how many messages will be there? 01, 02, 03, 04, 05, up to what? Up to 0, 8, right? Because there are 8 processes, right? So 0 process will have messages from 01 to 08. Again, this is the first process. How many messages it will have? Up to 1, 8. Okay, but 8. Okay, so we'll write, because 10 already we have written. So last is a 1, 8. In the same way, second processes will have the messages 20, 21, 22. But 22 it will keep with itself only. 23, 24, up to the 28. So it will have starting from 2, 0. 2, 1, and what will be the last message? That is a 2, 8, because there are the 9 processes. So these many messages they have. Now see, it's very simple. In the first step, communication will be done along the x-axis or along the rows. Okay, in rows. So see, here are the 3 rows. Okay, 1, 2, 3. So in this row, these nodes will share this message with itself. Okay, so 0, 1, 2, these nodes will share this message with itself, means all to all broadcast communication, all to all personalized communication will be done in between these 3 processes. Then all to all broadcast personalized communication will be done between these 3 processes. Then again, we are going row wise, right? So row wise. So here all to all personalized communication will be done between these rows, these processes. Okay, so communication will be done among these 3. At the same time, communication will be done among these 3. At the same time, communication will be done among these 3. This is the first step. Okay, this is the first step. And second step, in the first step, communication was done row wise, and in second step, communication will be done column wise. Likewise, okay. Here communication will be done column wise. Very simple. Row wise communication. So all these 3 rows, they are doing all to all personalized communication, but row wise. 0, 1, 2, they were doing all to all personalized communication. 3, 4, 5, they were doing all to all personalized communication. Now in second step, 0, 3, 6 will do, these nodes are along the column, right? Along the y axis also you can say. They are sharing messages with itself. They are doing all to all personalized communication. At the same time, 1, 4, 7, they are doing all to all personalized communication. At the same time, 2, 5, 8, they are doing all to all personalized communication. So it is very clear. Row wise communication and column wise communication. Now see, one thing that I wanted to mention here. When they are sending messages with each other, in the first step, just remember, first step, whatever the message, 0 process, right? In the first step, 0 will get message from the 1, 0 process will get message from the 2 also. So whatever the messages that particular process got in the first step, that it will exchange in the second step. So see, in the first step, 0 got message from 1, it got message from 2. So those messages it will forward to the 3 and 6. Okay, first process, in the first step it got message from 0, it has got message from 2. So all the messages it will forward to 4 and 7. Same way, 2 node, in the first step it got message from 0, it got message from 1. So it will transfer to 5 and 8. same way. Okay, same things will be applicable to this. So in first step, 3 got message from 4, 3 got message from 5. So what in second step, that 3 will do, it will share this message with the 6 and 0. In first step, 4 got message from 3 and 5. So in second step, what 4 will do, it will share message with the 7 and it will share with the 1. Same thing for the 5 and same thing for the other node. Now see, these messages are grouped together. So instead of sending these messages one by one, these messages are grouped together. How these messages are grouped? Look at this. See, 03 is the message. So 03 is the source, means this 0th process already had this message. Okay, just I zoom it out so it will be clear. Look at this. 03 is the message. So 0th node, it already had. 13 is a message that 0th process got from the first node. Okay, 23 is a message that 0th process got from the second node. So it will form one group of these three messages. Okay, and this combined message 0 will forward to 3. Now see, 06, that 0th node, it already had. So 06, 16, that is a message it got from one node, one first process. Because one is the source, right? One is the source. So that message it got from first process in the first step. 26 is the message, okay, that 0th process got from 2 in the first step. So it will make group of these messages, and that group of message, it will form single message of these, and it will forward to the 6. Okay, and every other node doing the same thing. For example, okay, so we'll focus on 3 because it is written like that, so it will better to understand. Now see, 3. Third process, 30, it already had, because 3 is the source. Okay, so 30 message 3 already had. 40 is the message that it got from the fourth node, and 50 is the message that 3 node got from the fourth node in the first step. Now third node will do, it will make a group of this, and this group of this will be forwarded to 0 node. In the same way, 36, so already third node had this message, because 3 is a source here, right? So third node had this message. 46, it has got from the fourth node in the first step. 56 is a message that third node got from the fifth node in the first step, right? So it will make a group of these messages, and that combined message that node 3 will forward to the sixth node, and every other node is doing the same thing. So see, within this two step, within this two step, first step and second step, all the nodes will get messages from all the other nodes. So in this way, all to all personalized communication is done over a mesh topology. So I have made it very clear, I made it very simple. Look at this, it's very simple. This is a mesh, it's a two dimensional structure. Nodes are kept like this, okay, along the rows and along the columns. 0th node, they have some messages like this. I have told, first is the source, another is the destination. So what messages 0 will have? 01, 02, 03, 04, 05. Because 0 is the source and another is the destination. What the message first process will have? 10, 12, 13 up to the 18. Because there are total 9 processes from 0 to 8. What second process will have? 20, 21 up to the 28, right? So first communication is done row wise, and in second step communication is done column wise. First step, these three nodes will do all to all personalized communication. These three nodes will do all to all personalized communication. These three nodes will do all to all personalized communication. In second step, all to all personalized communication will be done column by. So these three nodes will do all to all personalized communication. At the same time, this three node will do all to all personalized communication. At the same time, these three nodes will do all to all personalized communication. So this is how all to all personalized communication is done over mesh topology.